So welcome, Jerry McCarthy, to the 10-minute tea break at the New Theatre, where we clearly love alliteration. And you've on your third play that's about to open here, yes, called The Harvest. Previously you've had Epilogue and Overtime.
Yes.
Did I get that right?
Yes.
Very good.
In that order.
Okay, great. So we're going to have some rapid-fire questions.
Great. I'm ready.
Hit What's me. In your cup?
Coffee, which I actually don't drink ever, except when I'm in pre-production for a show and I need something in addition to sleep. So okay.
But you are in pre-production, so great.
Yes.
And bonus marks for a reusable cup.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, save the planet, save the trees.
When you're writing, where do you write? And what's your routine to get started?
So I'm getting a lot better at writing anywhere and having my laptop or pen, paper, whatever around. Not like Bob Dylan napkin kind of thing, but you're just doing it anywhere at any time, impromptu writing. Usually I write at home in the apartment, and we've got this lovely balcony and the kind of windows, and I have a pet magpie who comes down every day. And cries. I'm not making this up, I really do have a pet magpie. Nobody believes me.
Like, is it religious every morning?
No, I would like to say that it is, but it's not, because unless you're like a writer who can sustain themselves on their work, you're going to be doing other jobs as well. So it's a bit of juggling. And then if I have a deadline, I'll go to a library where I kind of work and get annoyed at all the people breathing really loudly.
Good tip though.
Yeah.
Inspiration question. What play or performance made you want to make theatre?
So this is going to sound like a roundabout question, but or answer, but it's actually true, and I'll get to the point. You will
okay.
see. I saw the film 12 Angry Men when I was about like 12, and it was the weirdest film I'd ever seen, because it was one location and it was just dialogue heavy, and all of the action was in the dialogue and the characters. And I thought, this is so strange. And I loved it. And when I looked into it, I realized that it was a play before it was a film. And I thought, oh my god, you can do so much. You don't have to have big action scenes, or you could do so much with just character and dialogue. So that was the first kind of play moment where I went, oh god, a play can do so much that no other form can do. And then also reading The Crucible in college and just going, oh my god, this is incredible.
Miller.
Yeah, Miller, big Miller fan.
Was there a live performance?
You see, I was trying to remember, just when you asked that question there, what my earliest experience of theatre was. And if I was to go by that, I'd be talking about this absolutely appalling production of the Scottish play I saw. We were all forced to go in school. So I actually think that was counterproductive, because that made me go, what the hell is, why am I here? This is terrible. So I was trying to give a live performance that I saw that I loved. I did see a really great Dan Reardon play here that was called Bleeding Poets with Lisa Lam. And I love that.
Ah,
and that was
great performers.
Great performers, yeah. Mm-hmm. And Dan was a writer, and he's a brilliant writer, so I loved that.
So, The Harvest.
Yes.
What was the first nugget, first bit of inspiration, you know, that made you start writing it?
I'm a really big podcast fan, and I get a lot of inspiration from listening to podcasts if I'm kind of going for a run or walking or just like cleaning. And one of my favourites is called This American Life, which is kind of, you know, like snippets from, you know, different stories around different themes. And there was one about a guy who had committed a crime years before, and through a series of different, you know, events and reasons, he didn't go to prison for it. And the whole story was about how this affected his life and who he was as a result of not doing the time for this. So that was the first inspiration for The Harvest. It's very different now. It's not remotely based on that guy. He was a lovely guy.
So you haven't given away spoilers.
No. It's a very, very different beast. But that was the first kind of, I kind of thought, what would that do to somebody? And that's a really interesting exploration, like, you know, who we are based on experiences that we have or don't have, or, you know, this sort of sliding doors idea of what we could have done.
And as a playwright, as a writer, who are the players that inspire you? Pick three.
Okay.
And for each of those three, one play.
Okay. Okay, I will say, well, Miller, Arthur Miller, Crucible, definitely. Mm-hmm. Love that. Carol Churchill, Top Girls, love that. Okay. Just specifically for the opening mm-hmm. scene, I just loved that when I saw it and then read it, the kind of all those different historical figures. I really love that. Mm. And Margaret Rowe. Marco Rowe, big fan, Marco Rowe, and I loved Our Few Evil Days.
Big plays.
And plays.
Big ideas.
Yeah.
Yeah, long structures. Yeah. Lots of characters.
Yeah, okay. We'd love to have lots of characters on stage.
Interesting. So you can see where you're going.
Yeah.
And on a similar type of what theatre inspires you, I'm just going to throw out a few names at you. And if you respond and say, what's your first thought? Speech, dialogue, image. So post-traumatic theatre
is where you see a terrible play and then go up to the
post-dramatic.
I guess is the sort of you know, the idea of like so it's all about kind of the performance and the audience connecting to the performance as opposed to the text, am I right?
So not your first love, I'm gonna guess. There. Yeah.
No, there is a fourth wall.
Yes. Yeah. So So Martin Crimp is not in the top three playwrights.
No.
Okay.
No.
Brecht.
Yeah, there's no fourth wall. That was what I would think of with Brecht, that there's no fourth wall, and that's, you know, that's what I always think of. And I always go, yes there is, in my head afterwards. No disrespect to Brecht, you know, because that's obviously, those are great things that he did, and they all feed into the different types of forms of theatre.
But that kind of leads me on to another question, which is, Brecht is great theatre, is about audience.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you think about your audience when you're writing?
I do think that the play doesn't take shape or take full form until it's performed in front of an audience, because you, even just as performers, you don't know what they're going to respond to and what part of the play they're going to respond to. And you can have all your ideas, and you can write your play and have your scenes and characters and where you think it's going to go and where you think it's going to take off. But until you have that live experience and the relationship that starts from, you know, lights down with the audience, the play doesn't exist until it's on stage. It's a living, breathing thing. So the audience is crucial. And I think if you're not considering them at all, then you've got a problem.
And with The Harvest, what would you like your audiences to feel? Or why do people need to see The Harvest?
They need to see it to make me happy. No, they need to see it. I think people need to see theatre in general. I think it's one of the few kind of unique art experiences, and that it can only happen like in that moment, and you going into this theatre with the actors in the play, that experience can only happen once, it'll never happen again. So that, there's something magic about that. But specifically The Harvest, I would like the audience to feel very tense. I would like them to be taken on a journey, they're not sure where they're going,
mm-hmm.
and for them to be surprised occasionally, to be surprised by their own initial ideas about the play. And not that it needs to be twisty and turny, but I would like them to be taken on a journey. And at the end, for them to feel changed in some way, emotionally or morally.
And I think we're just about out of time. So, the very last thing is, one word only, to describe The Harvest.
Intense.
Ooh. Thank you very much, Jane McCarthy.
The Harvest by me, Jane McCarthy, runs in the New Theatre from the 11th to the 23rd of June, Monday to Saturday at 7:30 p.m. You can get your tickets at thenewtheatre.com. Come see.